Hello guys, so this is the engine bay of our 2007 Ford Focus MK2 with the 1.6 liter machine. Yeah, and a couple of weeks ago I wanted to bring my wife to work and the motor was running really rough, and after a couple of minutes the check engine light started to illuminate us in its yellowly shining hue, and yeah, so now this is, could really be the end for the car. But then I decided we have to get the OBD2 dongle, and we selected the AutoScan Blue 2 here. That just was one which was on sale, and the reviews were not quite terrible. So, but that we found out that we got the error code P0304, cylinder 4 misfire. On the Focus, you can see here on the cables which number are the cylinders. So, cylinder 4 is this one, 3, 2, 1. It's also numbered on the coil here. We first hoped that it maybe just had been the spark plugs, because we, to my knowledge, we never exchanged them, and we have the car for I think over 5 years now. So, and they're certainly not looking quite good. Well, that probably lasted a couple of more kilometers, but yeah, was there certainly no error to exchange them, but this was what I could get in the local car parts store. So I got them, exchanged them. Actually, one hint here, which the store gave me: if you have a toolkit, you probably have the tool or the nut here for exchanging spark plugs, because I wanted to buy one and they were out, and I said, yeah, it's probably in your toolbox, and it wasn't my toolbox, so not the best, but it worked. So yeah, but sadly the spark plugs weren't a problem. So we're like €20 for the scanner tool, €20 for the spark plugs, and still nothing worked. But according to most people on YouTube who had the problem, it's probably the coil. So I got a new coil for €40 and exchanged this as well. There are videos out there how to exchange this stuff, but it's really not that complicated. You just have to get the four Torx screws out. It's a T25. The most difficult thing for me was getting the plug here off, because this has like a little security thing underneath. Once you get it off, it's really easy, so don't use too much force there. It's really more like pressing on the bottom the lock for the connector. Once that's loose, it really goes off without any resistance. So yeah, but that was the most difficult part for me. So yeah, with the coil exchange, it first looked like we still had a problem. Actually, I forgot one important detail: we got gas in the exhaust when we had it running for like 20 minutes on the parking ground. It got a bit wet, the exhaust, and smells like gasoline. So, and also additional information: if we would have driven with it in that condition, that would probably have damaged our catalysator and in the exhaust system, so that could have added quite some costs. I was very reluctant, or I didn't drive the car at all after we noticed that. I think I like drove it like 5 kilometers with the engine check light initially on. But yeah, then after exchanging, driving around a little bit and trying to delete the code, after a certain time it just cleared and everything works fine now. So really happy with that. Let's just show you guys how you can connect the OBD2 dongle in the Ford, because it's really, really easy. So if you're unsure if you have an OBD2 port, I think all cars after like 2004 are in Europe are required to have it. I think North America is a little bit later, and it was first necessary for gas cars and for diesel a little bit later. But yeah, in the Ford is really easy. You have the connector here, you can feel it. Get it in. That light indicates that it's working. Yeah, it's really easy to get it in. And then we use the app which was recommended by the manufacturer from the dongle, or one of them. This is in-car dock, and this was the light version, not the pro version. So yeah, really easy to get the code there. We could also delete the code, get some other engine information out there, but
that's the first thing, just to see what the error is. Yeah, and all in all, we paid 20 euros for the dongle, 20 euros for the spark plugs, 40 euros for the coil. I afterwards discovered that some vendors do sell a package bundle with spark plugs, coil, and the cables. The cable would be the third option. So if you see that, but now I checked and was all sold out. So if you see that bundle, that might save you a little bit of money overall. Or if you don't want to run into deep diagnostics, so I was also thinking I could try to get a spark plug checker, but actually, since we won't be using that car so many years now, it's the only car which has the OBD2 adapter which we have, so yeah, it's really not, we really don't want to waste too much money here, because probably next car in 2 or 3 years will be electric or something in that direction, and they are not required to have that stuff and might not work due to them not having an engine. Why should you want to check the engine control module? Yeah, but overall, car's running great now. Really happy we could fix it ourselves. Yeah, it was really easy. Yeah, if you had the same problem, let me know. If you didn't know better stuff, let me know. Because yeah, it's really like a 20 euro dongle. Actually, I'm not married to that one. There are much more expensive ones out there. If you do a lot of car repairs, it's probably worth to check out which ones are better, especially with the apps on the backside. Like, there are like general apps like Torque or this in-car dock here, which have a good free version, but also you have pro versions and more advanced apps, especially if you have multiple car types, multiple manufacturers. You might want to look deeper into it and may spend a little bit more money, but for us, it was really good with 20 euros. So, yeah, thanks for watching, guys. I hope I could help you if you had some car problems here. And yeah, see you soon. Bye bye.